Did you know that September is Red Cross Emergency Preparedness Month? Hey, Simplifiers, welcome back to Organizing with Simple Solutions. And this month, I would like to talk to you about organizing your family in case of emergency. And today, we're going to discuss creating an emergency plan for your family. So, first, I kind of want to talk about what would happen if there was an emergency in your home where you had to leave your home? For instance, if there was a fire. Be sure to go over with each member of your family where the exits in their bedrooms or the exits of the home are. It may seem very logical to you where you would leave if there was a fire in your house, but to a small child who might be scared, they might need someone to tell them so that when the event would happen, they would have recollection of, oh, there's a fire. I need to go to the nearest door or the nearest window, or this is the way I get out of my bedroom. I realize that this is a super scary topic to talk about, but I really, really think that it's important, no matter how old your kids are, to start discussing how to be safe and get out of your home safely in an emergency. So once you've discussed how to get out of your house, you need to discuss where to meet up. There should be two locations that your family plans to meet up in case of an emergency at your home. The first should be nearby. It should be like across the street at a light post, or at the nearest intersection, or on a neighbor's front porch. Make sure that everyone is aware that that is where anyone who was home at the time of the emergency should meet up for accountability. The next thing to discuss is where to meet up if not everyone was home. So, for instance, if my husband isn't here and there's an emergency in the home where my kids and I need to evacuate, we first go to point A, if we're not together at the time, and determine that all of us are there. And then we go to point B, which is where my husband will meet up with us. The reason you have that secondary place is if there's a fire emergency or a gas leak or something where he can't get down the street and get to our home. We want to know that we can meet up someplace safe to make sure that everyone is there and accounted for. Secondary place can be a park or a church or a grocery store or any other recognizable place that's near your home that your children and your spouse will remember where it is that you're supposed to meet up in case there is an emergency. And once you've established where these places are with your family, try to run a drill to make sure that the kids are aware of the exits and that they know where to go once they leave the house, and quiz them on where that secondary location would be. So, in case there's a relative or somebody else that will be picking the child up and bringing them to meet you, they are aware of where to tell that person to take them. You also want to consider your extended family when there is some sort of an emergency in your home. For instance, the recent hurricanes, or if there's a tornado or a wildfire around your home. I recommend changing your outgoing voicemail message as soon as you arrive in a safe place so that your extended family that may be trying to contact you will know that you are safe and sound. Try to do this as soon as you get to that safe place. That way, if the battery runs out on your phone, your family won't be trying to scramble and find out if you're okay. If the safe place that you've arrived at also has internet access, you may want to register through the American Red Cross Safe and Well site. And I'll put the link to that website in the description below. What this is a registry for people who are experiencing some sort of natural disaster or emergency so that the friends and family outside of that disaster zone can know that they are someplace safe or have some sort of shelter. And if you've noticed during recent disasters or emergencies, Facebook also has a way that you can check in and let people know that you're safe in case of an emergency. So do me a favor, sit down with your family tonight and make sure that they're aware of how to get out of your house in case there's an emergency where they need to leave, and where to meet up in case you get separated in that emergency. You won't be sorry that you had that conversation. And if you're in the Columbus area, I invite you to join me at Combustion Brewery and Tap Room on September 26th for a live Organize Your Family in Case of Emergency class. We'll be discussing a lot of the tips that I'll share with you this month on YouTube, and we'll also be building a car emergency kit in case you have an emergency in your car and you're stranded. And be sure to subscribe. so that you can join me during the entire month of September for tips on how to get your family organized in case of an emergency. Take care, happy organizing, and I'll see you next time with more tips on how to organize your family in case of emergency.